It's good to see everyone back. I'm Black Irish, TikTok new, YouTube, all those good channels, everything else. I'm doing my best. I'm going to spread myself all over the place. Make sure you get as much Man Cave and Black Irish as you can. And I do ask you, join my Patreon. I want to grow, and I don't want to YouTube grow. I want to grow beyond YouTube so I can give you the great content that you really deserve. So with all that out the way, let's get to the first video.
Then we're not getting that. We're not getting the all-inclusive. So then what am I paying for?
Well, you're paying for your stay. If it's a part of the all-inclusive, if you change your food, you can be able to dine. So you will get the food service.
She just told us that they closed. They even if we went and closed, they're not. I mean, even if we went and changed, they're not going to be able to get us in. You're talking to us, but what about talking to the people that work there that's telling us this? Well, let's go.
Yeah, I can already see where the problem is. So you think that just because it's called all-inclusive, you get to just do whatever the hell you want. No. You still got to abide by their rules, especially you being in a foreign country. You don't know how their customs are. You don't know how they work. You don't know how they roll. Honest truth is, I've been to plenty of all-inclusives all over the globe. They tell you that you got to dress a specific way. If it's depending on the restaurant, you got to dress a certain way or they won't let you in. That's their rules. It's not that you can't be all inclusive and enjoy it. It's just they're telling you you can't wear this. Don't know why it's such a difficult thing to understand. All right, because certain women like with the one in Italy, allegedly, and Dubai. Y'all just want to do what the hell you want.
Let's go and talk to this young lady.
So why don't you just go and change? Like, I don't understand what the problem is. Just change. Change your clothing. Why is that so difficult for some people? Some people to figure out.
Talk to the person about their procedures and how you deal with situation. I'm not going to address a person.
I'm not going to say anything. I'm asking you.
I will do it.
Okay, well then let's go do it.
You can go and change so you can get something to eat in the meantime.
They already told us we can't go eat. We don't have enough time. We don't want the buffet though.
You just said
you won't be able to get inside.
But you just said if we change, we can go back. But she's telling us something different.
Not there. The buffet, because the close off time would already be.
See, what she's saying is you can't go into this specific restaurant dressing the way you do. But the other one, you can go get the buffet and you good. Why is it you just can't figure this out? I do what I want. I do what I want. No, you can't. Y'all need to start. See, this is what irritates me with women that want to talk about the passport bros. Y'all all want to say the same thing. Oh, you don't know the customs. You don't know how things work. I mean, their family is this way. You can't even figure out dress code. You can't even figure out a simple dress code to get into their restaurants. And I say their restaurants. This isn't Jamaica, man. You don't dress like this. You got to look like you're fashionable, not like you walk in the streets, boy. See, the problem is y'all don't understand. Y'all been Americanized for too damn long. You're walking around thinking that this is cool. Other countries are basically letting you know this isn't cool. I shouldn't have to tell you this. You a grown-ass woman. Every time I go out to dinner, or any one of us, we go out to dinner, what's the dress code? Okay, this. Then we get accordingly, or we just don't go.
Okay,
we didn't pay to put a stop on my credit card, because we'll talk about this all-inclusive stuff at another time. Because
And I will be putting this on the internet.
This is not an all-inclusive.
At all.
So,
and I hope you know you're dealing with people with large followings.
Oh my God, I got large followings and they're going to know about it. And you're going to go bankrupt overnight. I'm sorry, honey. This ain't the Budweiser light boycott. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. You think they're gonna like that? Jamaica is gonna go sat. Is gonna go, you know, belly up, and people aren't gonna go to these resorts. No, no one cares. Smart people, adults, non-mentally challenged people, they all know that. Okay, I have to dress a certain way. They said you can go to the buffet. They said you can't dress like this. I do what I want. Clearly, you can't.
Well, no, this is my phone, so I can record what I want to.
Yeah, I think you need to understand that as well. You ain't in America, honey. You in Jamaica. You got to follow their laws. Why is it? Like I said, oh, the passport bros, they just doing all this other stuff. Y'all don't even know the laws you countries you traveling to. I'm going to be doing a video about this chick who goes to Italy and is complaining because the staff said you can't bring food into the room from outside. So she's like, I'm going to do what I want. And then when they got up in her face, she didn't know what to do. Now, I don't know if this is true or not, but you're stupid. You're that dumb that you're going to go out here and just start pretending like you in America and think that people are going to tolerate that crap. See, this is the problem. They made you feel a little thing called privilege. And these other countries are bringing you back to reality.
Like I said, I have a big following, so I will be putting this on the internet. Thank you. You forgot this.
They never seem to learn what happened to Dubai. That Dubai girl, she gone bye-bye because she wanted to get all up. I don't care what her lawyer says. Oh, she was just doing it because she was being a woman. Okay, that's their laws. Don't go there then. If there's a place that goes around and lynching men, you think I'm going to go to those countries? No, I'm going to avoid them like the plague. If there's a part of Central Park that just likes to grape men, am I going to go to that certain part? No, I'm not going to go there. Certain people, I go where I want to go. All right, enjoy that grape. Keep your butthole tight. So I'm going to go. This is a video I wanted to talk about. This is a, whatever her name is. Freaking Mr. Incredible over here. Now, just look at the video. Apparently, she had a video where she was trying to call out some dude that was like harassing her or some crap. But just, I want you to pay some very close attention to something. Well, I know that you've been waiting for it. I'm waiting too. In my imagination, I'll be all up on you. I know you got that fever for me, 102. And boy, I know I feel the same. My temperature's through the roof. If it's a camera up in here, then it's only you for me. When I do. All right, so that's enough. So we already know where this is going. She's on TikTok, and she does exactly what most women like herself do. They go out there and do the best they can, which is not come up with, I don't know, anything philosophical or anything intellectual. It's just showing off their assets. And she's got a nice body. She works out. Me, personally, I think her body looks nice, but her mug is just straight up Mr. Incredible. So she's going to basically do this video where she calls out some dude. I guess he's a simp or whatever, but let's just play it.
Y'all, are y'all ready for some?
Show that shit. Oh, man, that shit will break a cinder block. Like, come on. Like, and she in the short hair, like, oh, like, is it me? Like, all this, is it just black guys that just love white women with short hair? I mean, I'm not mad at you, but it's just like, I don't get it. Like, whatever. Let's just get to this video. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Piping hot tea right now. A couple weeks ago, this guy right here asked me for my number at the gym. I gave him my number. He texted me as soon as he left the gym. I was still in the middle of my workout, so I didn't respond. So then he calls me, and I didn't answer.
All right, so I can already start see where this is going. First of all, she's trying to make herself sound like she's got so many things going on in her world. Oh, I didn't have time for that. Then he tried to call me. I was still pushing up that weight. I didn't have time to do it. She's an egomaniac. She's just looking for that attention. And I'm just like, come on, girl. We know who you're targeting when you make these videos. And that's cool. But don't have that ego. The ego part just turns the whole thing off. in face value, it's that. Your face turns everyone off. But like you're just interacting with you, you have serious issues.
So when I didn't answer, he texts me, "Would you mind calling me?" And then proceeds to tell me he just transferred his job and he wants to date and financially support me. I was like, this is just a little too weird for me. He kept calling, so I eventually blocked his
number. So you liked him enough to give him your number, though. Like, you were so busy working out, but you gave him your number. And then he texts you, but now all of a sudden you're too good to pick up the phone. And I'm not if this is real, I'm not saying he's not a simp. I'm just saying you had attraction to him enough to give him the phone.
Number.
And your actual phone number.
Haven't seen or heard from him since until now. It is 11:30 p.m. on Saturday evening, and I get a call from no caller ID. I'm like, who the hell could this be? But I answered it. Now this
because you can't help it. It's like that phone booth, that phone ringing. You just got to answer. You're so curious. You just can't leave it alone. See, me personally, I don't answer phone numbers I don't know. Bill collector? No, I don't got time for you. I got time for that. But you, you got to pick up that phone. You're lonely.
Conversation went on for, let me see. So the call lasted for a total of 2 minutes, and I was in such shock at first that I didn't know what to do. I ran and got my iPad and started recording the last minute. This is why we don't give men our number.
Wait, hold on a second. Why did you have to get your iPad? You know... Oh, you got an iPhone. I don't know. Anyone can tell me. If you have an iPhone, you can't record straight from your phone. See, you should have got with the Droid. Galaxy can do that without having to go all that nonsense. I had, like, you doing it like it's like iPhone just came out and you got to take two devices just to record one damn device. You can screen time a video of your own phone. Anyway, let's continue.
Okay, let me show you how this guy was just talking.
I'm sorry, that shin is just too much, girl. Like, if you just, like, from, like, the neck down, you'd be fine. I personally think that you should just rock, like, a Mexican mask, a Mexican wrestler mask, and just put eyelashes on them. Like, that would be probably more appealing than looking at that shin. The problem is your chin would just be popping out through the mask, and I would just know it's that face is under there.
Talking to me on the phone.
Bitch, you can't keep a mask.
So you couldn't even succeed at that. You couldn't even get a text back. You couldn't get a text back, so you have to call me with no caller ID. No caller ID, really, bro? Really, bro?
Bitch.
And you're not? Single. And you're not?
No, you were just a quick fuck. I was just trying to fuck you.
But you're not single?
No, never. I
sent a picture. Well, I feel sorry for her then. I feel sorry because you're trying to come at me. Oh my God. You're about to be so famous all over the fucking world.
Yeah, he's a simp. Dude, my guy. Bobby, what the heck were you thinking, bro? Yeah, you were so horny that you lost it because the chick wouldn't write you back. Listen, here at the Man Cave, I will call out other dudes. I will 100% do it. When you do some stuff like this, I'm going to call you out. Like, my guy, what were you thinking? You called her. Oh, my. Like, I can't even, like, she's Mr. Incredible. Like, you think she ain't the top of her game? What is wrong with you, bro? And then you go on a tantrum.
I wish you would. You're about slap to the so shit out of me when he sees me.
Buddy, I'm going to blast your picture along with this recording.
And you sent her a picture. Dude, listen, I'm on her side with this. You're an idiot. You are an idiot. You went out of your way to men. Every other man, look at what he did. Do not do this. She's looking for attention, but this dude's an idiot. Do not do what he did. ever. If you or one of my subscribers, don't ever do this.
Because guess what?
You a dumb bitch.
Always oh, dumb I'm going to keep being a dumb bitch, and I'm going to show 1.1 million people on TikTok.
And then he hung up. So here, my friends, this is Julius. That is how Julius treats women who he can't fuck. But he's got a girlfriend. But he wanted to date and financially support me. I don't know. This is not how I expected to end my night, but...
Oh, man. Why did you do it? See, this is sad. My God. Why would you do that? I hope it's fake, but I don't think it's fake. I think he legit sent the picture. He legit said all those things. Okay, this is when I say when women find men creepy, this is the real version of what women should say creepy is. When you go out here and you're like, I'm ready to take care of you and financially. When you leave with your wallet, you're automatically placed in two characters, either friend zone or just straight up creep. And they'll use you. My guy, start getting some dignity for God's sakes. And for everyone else, I don't even know what to say. Like, regardless of how I feel about her, he was an idiot. Just straight up. There's just no way to get around it. The man cares not taking the L, but he definitely is.